American football now from London, England.
4 years ago, Britain waited eagerly for the birth of the first new television channel for over 20 years. In November 1982, Channel 4 was born. And among a host of new programs and new ideas came a new sport. Football is now an established part of Channel 4's schedule, and the sport has won a place in the nation's consciousness. But tonight, American football enters a new era. At London's Wembley Stadium, the NFL goes international, and this home of British football opens its doors to the best of American sport. From Chicago come the world champion Super Bowl winning Bears, all the way from the Windy City to Wembley's Twin Towers. And from Texas to Middlesex come the Dallas Cowboys, America's team, the champions of the National League Eastern Division. These top teams do battle tonight for the American Bowl 86. Hello again, everybody. I'm Frank Gifford, and it'll be my pleasure to bring you the action from the NFL here on Channel 4 throughout the coming season, as well as continuing to host ABC's Monday Night Football in the United States. You know, I don't think in my playing time with the New York Giants and in the NFL I would have ever believed that one day I'd be seeing a match played here in London. But here I am. American football, the hottest ticket in town, and everybody wants to talk to football. John Smith, I don't know, we imported you to the United States. Now all of a sudden, look what you've done to us. You turned the tables completely around. You got us all over here.
Well, when I came to the States to play in the NFL in 1973, football was virtually unheard of. People thought I was crazy coming to the States to play a foreign game. In fact, the first game of football I ever saw was the first one I was in. But now we have over 200 teams in the UK playing every weekend.
It is amazing.
The Patriots, I know, get letters every week asking for media information, photographs, schedules. British people even plan their vacations around the NFL schedule. So now we have a sellout in Wembley. Incredible growth in 4 years, Frank.
And you know, all of America's talking about it too. The fact that football has caught on over here, they're as shocked as I am. It really is something. You know, if all the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players, we have some pretty interesting characters built for tonight's performance.
One man who's played many parts in his time is William Perry, the refrigerator. His entry onto the NFL stage last season was sensational. Sharing the spotlight with Perry will be Walter Payton, the uncomplaining hero of a number of Chicago flops down the years, but the star of a smash hit in 1985. And orchestrating the Bears tonight will be quarterback Jim McMahon, an outrageous performer on and off the field. He rarely is away from center stage. Playing a starring role for the Cowboys will be quarterback Danny White, who in recent years has had more than his share of disappointments. But now his understudy Gary Hogaboom has been traded, and White will be in charge tonight. And this man will run, run, and run. Tony Dorsett, the Cowboys star running back for the past decade. And two of the great actor managers of the game will be directing affairs tonight. Tom Landry, beginning his 27th year as Dallas coach, with 5 NFC titles and 2 Super Bowl victories behind him. In his 3rd season directing the Chicago Bears is one of Landry's former assistants, Mike Ditka.
A couple of colorful coaches. Just briefly, before we get underway here, let me tell you about the full season of American football that lies ahead here on Channel 4. Tomorrow, you can see the NFL in London, which looks at the Bears and Cowboys' week-long stay here in London. That's at 9 o'clock. Then on September the 7th, we whet your appetite for the new season with highlights of the 1986 Pro Bowl, the AFC versus the NFC, in American football's All-Star Game. Now, the regular season begins here on Channel 4 on Sunday, September the 14th. We'll bring you the best action every week on Sundays at 6 o'clock until Christmas, when we reach the playoffs. And this season, we'll bring you the games just after they've happened, with NFL coverage on Sundays and Mondays in January. Then John and I will be at the Rose Bowl in Los Angeles, California on January the 25th for Super Bowl 21. So make sure you'll be in front of your screen that night. And we can reveal tonight that Channel 4 will have World Series Baseball for you in October. So there will be plenty of colorful sports action throughout the entire autumn. Before we kick off tonight's game between the Bears and the Cowboys, let me tell you a little bit about the difference between preseason play in the NFL and regular season play. In preseason, each team usually has about 80, 90, even 100 players that they bring to training camp. Of course, by the start of the season, they have to be down to 45 players. That means that a lot of players that you're going to watch tonight, you will never watch again, you'll never hear of again, because they will be, as we say in America, cut. That means that they go home. That's it. Their professional careers are over unless they can attach on to another team. Consequently, the coaches tonight, as they get ready to get down to a 45-man roster, are going to look at a lot of players. So you will probably see a Walter Payton in the first quarter, maybe the third quarter. You will not see him throughout the entire game as you would in regular season. Tony Dorsett, the same thing. Danny White, and of course, Jim McMahon, and right on through the roster. So you are going to be looking at a lot of players tonight. Believe me, you will never hear from again. But that's the nature of the game. That's how they get to the 45-man rosters. And of course, our game is vastly different than your game of football. The rules are different. The way we go about it is different. The strategy is different. So why don't we let John explain a little bit with a Washington-Dallas game of a couple of years ago. Here's John.
As we hold the action, Washington in red have the ball on their own 30-yard line. Playing from left to right, Washington have four attempts, known as downs, to gain a total of at least 10 yards and retain possession. It's first and 10, their first attempt with 10 yards to go. Washington can move the ball by running with it or passing it. You can pass backwards or forwards. Let's see what happens. In fact, they run with it. The quarterback, Joe Theismann, hands the ball to running back John Riggins, who gains 4 yards before being tackled. A gain of 4 yards. 6 left to go. Second down coming up. So it's second and 6. Again, the Skins run the ball. Another gain of 4 yards by Riggins. So now 8 gained in total, 2 to go, but it's third down. Third and 2. This time, Washington pass. Theismann drops back and prepares to throw. As his receivers set off downfield, let's consider the possible outcomes. 1, Washington catch the pass, the play is complete and they retain possession. 2, the opposition catch the ball, an interception, and they have possession. 3, no one catches the ball, the play is incomplete, Washington retain possession. No yards are gained or lost, but the down is wasted. Let's see what in fact happened. A perfect pass. Art Monk, the wide receiver, makes a good catch, and Washington have easily gained their 10 yards. They retain possession. Washington start another series of 4 downs. They've moved to the opposition's 40-yard line and are in a scoring position. First and 10. Washington go for the pass immediately. Perfect again. Their tight end makes a clean catch and sprints into the end zone for a touchdown. 6 points. After a touchdown, an extra point can be added with a successful kick. Instead of going for a touchdown, a team will sometimes attempt a field goal worth 3 points.
So it is a little different. Don't worry about it. It took us a long time to figure it out. Right now in this fine old stadium, which has seen a great exhibition, a World Cup, and Olympic Games, and just 2 weeks ago, a world title fight, it's the Chicago Bears against the Dallas Cowboys at Wembley. Our match commentators are NBC's Merlin Olsen and Dick Enberg.
The Cowboys and the Bears, and indeed a very attractive game presented to the fans here in England. We're live here in many parts of England and throughout the continent of Europe.
Nice to be able to finish our season in the Super Bowl, a game broadcast all around the world, and here we are with an international flavor to our kickoff of the 1986 season.
The Cowboys to kick it off. Rafael Septien, who is in a battle for his professional life with a rookie draft of Max Sandejas, will kick it off. Willie Gault and Dennis Gentry are deep for the black jersey Bears.
Gault and Gentry are deep.
See a flashing bulb at the 8. The speedster Gault
And he drives out to the 27-yard line. Gault, who performed as a U.S. Olympian prior to the games that didn't happen for the Americans in Moscow in 1980. The Bears have Jim McMahon at quarterback, the same lineup basically that started in the Super Bowl with Sui and the great Walter Payton in the backfield. Ken Marjoram for Dennis McKinnon, who missed the 1986 season with an injury. Gault on the other side, the tight end Emory Moorhead. An excellent offensive line. Covert, Bortz, Hilgenberg, Thayer, and Van Horn. Payton has not played in the first game of the preseason in some 7 years. He's very much against it, but because of the nature of this game, he does start tonight. McMahon to Sui. And the fullback has a first down as he rips out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Eugene Lockhart with a tackle, and here are the Cowboys on defense. Too tall, Jones. John Dutton may lose his job this year. Randy White, again an All-Pro 8 straight years, and Jim Jeffcoat up front. The linebackers, Hegman, Lockhart, and Rohr. Everson Walls and Ron Fellows at the corners. Bill Bates starts for Dexter Klingscale, who is now reported to Dallas, and Michael Downs, the other safety. First down there at their own 38. The tight end Moorhead in motion. It's Payton. And fans get a taste of the National Football League's all-time running back, Payton, as he gathers 5 yards in the grasp of Jim Jeffcoat.
Dick, one of the things that's going to be interesting for us is to watch the reaction of this crowd. I'm talking to Jim Hart, who was quarterbacking the Cardinals when they were here before. He said they were a very quiet crowd. They didn't understand the game. He said sometimes they cheered and we didn't know what they were cheering about. Often they booed. We didn't know what they were booing about. This is a much more informed crowd that we have here today.
Well, Channel 4 in London has received duly much credit for the education of this game to the British audience. Second and 5, McMahon out of the backfield, incomplete through the hands of Payton, who had a job with his own hands full of Jeff Rohr, the linebacker. It's 3rd and 5.
We talk about Walter Payton, his great running ability, the fact that he is the all-time leading rusher in the NFL. He also happens to be Chicago's leading pass receiver. You don't see him drop many passes like that. Ooh, ouch. Jeff Rohr up to give him a little burp.
And he'll start the season not only with those 14,860 rushing yards, but the all-time Bear receiver with 422 catches, and not a bad passer, as we know as well. Jeffcoat was offside, flag down. McMahon over the middle, finds Ken Marjoram, but he's short of the first down at the 46-yard line. But the penalty might give the Bears that additional 4 downs anyway.
It looks like they'll make it by inches if they mark it off according to where the markers are on the sideline. Yes, there it is.
Dallas, offside.
McMahon doesn't need any time to make that decision. He'll take the 5. And we'll see whether that will give the Bears the first down. Yes, it will. So first down, Chicago, at the 48-yard line in Bear territory.
5 yards offside.
The field has accepted all that rain very well. The drainage system outstanding here. Of course, it's the European football, soccer played here at Wembley.
It's also a flat field. Usually our fields have a crest to them. This one is almost dead flat.
Gault, the sprinter, to the near side, out of your picture, and Marjoram comes in motion behind McMahon. Payton stopping on a dime and then diving into Cowboy territory to the 49. Picked up by Rohr. Hickman was there as well, along with Lockhart.
You wonder at what has allowed Walter Payton to make all that yardage. Watch the way he changes direction here. It's absolutely amazing the kind of control he has over his body. And even on a slick field, a quick change of direction, and then just threads his way through all of those arms and bodies for a gain that is not big, but certainly important.
Payton, 32 years young, Jackson State. On second down, through the hands of Gault, and he was open on the near side. Ron Fellows was some 7 yards behind him.
Jim McMahon kind of kicking himself. That pass thrown a little bit over the head of Willie Gault. And of course, when you give the ball to a sprinter like Golf, and then he's out in the open like that, he's only got one or two people to beat into the end zone. Bear is, of course, using that kind of play very effectively during the last season, and Golf really came of age in 1985.
Especially in the playoffs. On third down, this huge crowd very quiet at the moment. Out of the shotgun, McMahon. Stands like this. McMahon has stopped what appears to be short of the first down at the 38. Victor Scott, number 22, the fifth defensive back in on the hit. McMahon and the Bear offense leaving the field, so here comes their kicking unit.
Sure that Mike Ditka doesn't like to see McMahon run the football, but McMahon's philosophy is very simple. He says, I'll do anything I can to win the game, to pick up the first down. You see him flying to the inside there and throwing himself. Downs one of the men up to make the tackle, but just short of that first down.
Maury Buford, good year in 85, averaged over 42 yards a punt. Errol Banks is deep, former Stanford star. He'll let that one go into the end zone. Well out of it. So the Cowboys will initiate their first offensive series from the 20-yard line. 11 minutes, 45 seconds remaining in the opening period in London. Bears and the Cowboys. The Cowboys and the Bears. And now it's Dallas and White, their turn. And Danny White, the 34-year-old veteran from Arizona State, brings him out of the huddle. Mike Renfro had his best year ever last year, his first with the Cowboys. And the veteran Tony Hill out of the backfield to Timmy Newsom, the fullback. He runs right through the hip of Dave Dorison and picks up five before Mike Richardson can secure the tackle. Here are the Cowboys on offense. White with Newsom and Tony Dorsett, only 1,500 yards away from number two all time. Hill and Renfro on the outside. Doug Cosby, a Pro Bowler at tight end. Schultz, Titanser, Rafferty, Kerr, his dad used to be a guard at Buckingham Palace. Scottish guard and Jim Cooper, the offensive line. On second and five, it's Dorsett springing into the open. And Dorsett with 15 yards and a first down at the 40. Dorson made the hit.
16 yards on that play, and that brings life from this crowd. They're delighted at the explosive play. Tony Dorsett, still the key man in this Dallas offensive plan. You see him breaking clear of Mike Hartenstein right there. The refrigerator Perry throwing himself in from behind. But it's a big gain for Dallas. They're just out to the 40-yard line.
Hartenstein in for Dan Hampton, who is not in uniform tonight. He's up here with us, helping us with the identification of the Bears. Out of the eye, Dorsett into a crowd and yard at this. Here is that Bear defense with Hartenstein and Steve McMichael in on that last tackle. And that front four, along with the refrigerator, William Perry. You can't believe what a hero he is and the publicity he received during the course of this week in London. Of course, Richard Dent, the Super Bowl MVP at the other end. Wilson, Singletary, and Marshall, that same three linebacking group that starred in the Super Bowl with Richardson and Phillips, Dorison and Fensick, the back four. Second and nine. No score. Approaching the midpoint of the first quarter.
Players put points on the board. They pick it up right where they left off last year. They've got a lot of black shirts out there on Tony Hill. Watch him as that ball just squirts free right there. He's trying to reach up. I think it was a foot that got it. I think Reggie Phillips got it with his foot, knocked it out. And there's Dorsett opportunely picking up that football and racing untouched into the end zone.
Kevin Butler, who led the NFL in scoring last year, to try the point after out of Steve Fuller's hold. Look at the light bulb splash as Butler nails one down the middle. That's like a free kick in their game of football. Dorson, the touchdown maker, and with 9 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the first period, the Bears by 7. Here's a nice touch for this young man, Russell Wilsmer. He's 27 years of age, went to the College for Distributive Arts here in England. He plays in the Budweiser League, a league of some 72 American football teams, and the Bears signed Wilsmer yesterday. Now in front of 80,000 fans, he kicks off for the American Super Bowl champion. Duckett and Levett are deep for the Cowboys. Assistant coaches in the process. Well, as they discuss the penalty, here is the young British kicker and his feelings about tonight.
I'd be nervous, yeah, but after the first kick, I'm sure I'll be settled. It's going to be the first return that's going to be the big problem when they return it.
I don't know whether he received any contact, but hopefully he didn't stand long admiring the height of his kick.
Cowboys denied a very fine return by Levett as Brian Storm, linebacker, attacked for a holding call on that play, and they'll move it back to the 11-yard line.
Tom Landry, the dean of NFL coaches, now 62 years of age, returning to England, first time since a bomber pilot in World War II. From the 11, matching Danny White's number, out of the backfield, good catch by Newsom, and he's out of bounds after a game. At the 14.
One of the things the Chicago Bears will be doing more of in this season is playing a 3-4 defense. One of the questions that's being asked, because the Bears were so unique last year in their defensive formations, they made it very difficult. Look at some of the ways in which they led the NFL in 1985. And of course, if you begin to play formations that are easier to read for the defense, it may be easier for them to pick up the talent of this Bear defense.
There's a man who replaced Buddy Ryan. We saw him briefly in the orange jacket, Vince Tobin. Second and 7, Dorsett. Just a couple. And that's the big question that fans around the country are asking about the Bears. Now you've got the best defense by far, maybe one of the best ever in the NFL, and then you change it. The old expression, why fix it if it's not broken?
Well, I think what's going to happen, I think Vince Tobin is going to put a defensive scheme in, and then he'll use what works. It seemed to me that he is going to make adjustments to what really works, and that is based on the kind of personnel you have on the field. Bears right now on a 4-man line, and that, of course, that was the trademark of the defense that they ran last year, although they put those 4 down linemen in strange positions.
3rd and 4, and incomplete off the hands of Tony Dorsett, and the Cowboys will have to punt it away.
Dick, the other thing we're seeing in the early going for Dallas, a very high emphasis on throwing to the running backs, and that's one of the things that we're going to see throughout the season, because Paul Hackett believes that the ball goes to them on a quick pass, a quick outlet. You give them the chance of taking what is in effect a long handoff, and then they've got to beat one-on-one those linebackers and secondary people.
Mike Saxon, who averaged just under 42 a kick last year, San Diego State. Keith Ortego back at the Bear 39. Saxon will deliver from around his own 8-yard line, and it's a beauty. Ortego driven back to the 31, 35, and down at the 39. Good coverage, and right in the thick of things, Bill Bates, number 40, Steve DiAssi, number 55, and Johnny Holloway, the rookie from Kansas, 34, his number. Tokyo, Mexico City, London, and again here in 1986 in London, England, the NFL presenting its exciting package. Henry Moorhead did not control the football as he was hit by Bill Bates out at the 45-yard line. will be selecting the Budweiser Most Valuable Player for today's game. Might choose along with us. That's going to be an interesting.
We have a lot of players to select from.
170 potential, 85 in uniform for each side. Some of them with the same number. We have several instances where two players have the same number, same team. Second and 10 from the 39. Peyton starts out on the wing with Sui behind McMahon. Marjoram, a little hitch and go down the sidelines, but it was read very well by Everson Walls. Walls, 24 at that left corner. What a job for a free agent, the Dallas native. Walls intercepted 11 passes when he was a senior at Grambling, led the NCAA. No one drafted him, and now is NFL player, the only man to win the interception title three times. He had nine last year. McMahon, 1 for 5. Throwing, and will work out of the shotgun on 3rd and 10. Going deep, Marjoram, and it's not there. So three incomplete passes, and McMahon will go to the sidelines, think that over, and the Cowboys will get the football.
Mike Ditka has been a little bit angry all during this week, and in particular unhappy with the timing of his passing game. Not so much at his first line quarterbacks and receivers, but that may change. He might be a little unhappy. That's what, 1 out of 6 here in the early going. Man, not finding his receivers very well so far.
Gordon Banks back at the 16 for Dallas. As Buford delivers, a flag down. Banks at the 12. It's a block.
One of the Chicago Bears moved just before that snap, Dick. I think they're going to bring it back and make the free kick. Plus Dallas opts to take the ball right there on the, it's about the 19-yard line. They're going to bring it back.
And one of the fans has left his position and wandered out onto the field. And you best learn that those fellows with those helmets sometimes take unkindly to the presence of an invader, and is let off the field.
The legal motion penalty, 5 yards.
Well, there's a familiar voice. You hear the PA.
We heard that voice a long time.
Yes, we did. John Ramsey at the Coliseum in Los Angeles, the voice of the Rams for so many years. McMahon to kick it, Buford to kick it again from Texas Tech. He said, boy, talk about the luck of the draw to be picked up by the Chicago Bears and have that Super Bowl experience, he said. Leaving the 6 months flying by every day seemed to be full of sunshine, the way the Chicago fans treated the Bears this last half year. End over end this time. And not played by Banks. It'll roll just about where Banks had it on the last kick, about the 17-yard line. And a timeout goes with it. 7 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in the opening period at Wembley Stadium in London, England, where the Bears on a 48-yard touchdown by Dorson Lee. Our director, Ted Nathanson, an international television crew, a seminar yesterday.
Okay, I think we've gone over everything now. Does anybody have any questions about anything?
Yes, on a double reverse, when the runner passes the line of scrimmage and then laterals back to the quarterback, how do you want us to cover that?
As best you can. Don't worry, it won't happen.
As best you can. I'll do a great job.
Many of us may have missed anything so far in this ball.
That's right. Many of the same blokes that worked with us at Wimbledon have through the years, from Trillium. The refrigerator Perry gets his name called in on that last tackle of Timmy Newsom.
Dick, I'm glad you didn't eat all the strawberries and cream while you were here for Wimbledon. There was still a little bit left for us on this trip.
The weather has been just delightful the entire week until today. There's Perry. We might see him. There are a couple of plays in offensively, and we might see Perry at linebacker, another new wrinkle in the Bears defense. Second down and 8. Danny White. fly down the middle in and out of the hands of Doug Cosby, the tight end.
Mike Singletary. What an outstanding little linebacker covering tight on the tight end that's knocked that ball away. Down in the pits, William Perry, the refrigerator himself on the inside. Driving class number 63, Glenn Titanser, doing a good job of getting some pressure on Danny White, forcing that ball to be thrown just a second before they wanted to get through it.
22.6 stone is apparent, and that's being kind.
That is being kind.
14 pounds to the stone, but he's referred to as a William the refrigerator at 22 plus stone.
I think he may have picked up a bit over here. I think, but too.
Couple of pebbles, anyway. On third and eight, it's to Dorsett, and it doesn't fall. Perry and a fumble. Dorsett is after it again. A free ball, and Reggie Phillips covers for Chicago.
Well, the exact reverse of what happened on the last one. Reggie Phillips forced the fumble. Dorsett took it in for the touchdown. That time, Dorsett had another shot at it, and it was Reggie Phillips who comes up with a big turnover. Let's go back inside and see what's happening in the pits on that play. Getting a look right there as Perry works on Rafferty, the center. And there goes Dorsett to the outside. It's Perry who strips that ball away. There's Dorsett having a chance. I'm sure he's looking and saying, 14 points, I got 14. But he couldn't scoop it up on the run. And it's Reggie Phillips who ends up with the football. But great field position, a second turnover. The Bears, of course, led the league in turnover ratio in 1985.
And this was the pleasant duty of McMahon to bring the offense on the field inside the opponent's 20-yard line. Gives to Suey, and he's crunched just inside the 15. And we've got a little scuffle there away from the play.
Gene Lockhart locking up with one of the Bears. Jay Hilgenberg. I'm sure one of the things that will motivate these Dallas players in this game today is the memory of their worst defeat ever, a shutout in Texas, 44-0 toward the end of the season.
Worst ever,
and only their second shutout in history. A game, I'm sure, that still sticks in the craw of head coach Tom Landry and all of those guys in those white uniforms.
But no mercy from the Bears. Ditko would still enjoy another victory over his former mentor. McMahon to Payton. Spinning down to the 12-yard line. Shy of the first down. There were some balls. Ditka, Mike Hickman.
Ditka credits Landry, Dick, as you know, for much of his development as a coach. In fact, second only to George Halas as an impact on him. He tells a great story. He said that when he was the special teams coach, they were playing the Giants, and he decided to call an onside kick on his own. And they almost got the ball and went out of bounds, and he said as they lined up to kick again, he kept going as far as he could away from Landry. Landry just came down, looked on the field, didn't look at Dick, and said, if you ever do that again, you'll be looking for a job.
Well, McMahon out of the shotgun, third and five, trying to take advantage of that second fumble recovery here in the first quarter. And thanks to Payton, Dallas native, joining Everson Walls as a couple of free agents.
I think maybe McMahon did that on his own. The call to everybody, it seems to believe, that's the naked quarterback reverse. And just a great reaction by Downs to get in there and get a hold of McMahon. But that, again, the typical McMahon play. Doing the unexpected and doing anything he can to help his team win. And they're going for it here. Fourth and a yard.
No field goal try and no William Perry in the backfield. Fourth and one. Payton and Suey behind McMahon.
Well, some consternation. And McMahon, they apparently were in the wrong formation. You could see Payton and Suey conversing back there. McMahon wisely looking back, realizing that there was some confusion, simply took the timeout rather than blow the opportunity.
Now that's one of the differences between the fan reaction from now and 3 years ago. Before, with a mistake developing, they wanted it to be the way it is in European football, to play through it. Here, a timeout used to avoid the error with 4 minutes and 31 seconds remaining. First quarter. The 36-yard line of the Cowboys. Outnumbered by those cheering for the Bears here in London, have a chance to see a terrific fill of a hole by Lockhart.
Eugene Lockhart last year did not have the kind of season he'd had as a rookie. The thought was that he was doing too much thinking. Well, there's a very difficult job in there to master all of the response of that middle linebacking position for the Cowboys to handle the calls of the defense. Lockhart told me earlier this week, he said, "I'm feeling much more comfortable, more relaxed. I think it's going to allow me to play better football," and if that's any indication, I think he's right.
Now the Cowboys down 7-0. A fumble return for a score by Dave Dorson, 48 yards, and then another fumble recovery inside the Dallas 20. But the defense of the Cowboys halts the Bears shy of any further scoring.
A very big play, too. Had the Cowboys not been able to stop the Bears there, they go ahead 14-0. They could change their whole philosophy in the way they approach this game. By shutting them out of the scoring opportunity, taking over the ball, now they can move down this field, hopefully, and get themselves back on the scoreboard, back into the ballgame.
Two tight ends used by White and the Cowboys, the only running back, Newsom. And it is Timmy Newsom. The refrigerator lands some defrost on those running backs.
When William Perry came into the league last year, there were a lot of jokes made about drafting someone of his size, and Buddy Ryan, the Bear coach, the defense at the time, poked some ridicule at Perry himself. But he has amazed us with his quickness, with the way he has learned to play in that defensive tackle position, and, of course, has thrilled a lot of people by the other antics which he's exhibited as a running back and as a character.
Man of many nicknames in just one short year in the NFL. We'll share some of those with you. White batted in the air. The hands of Marshall and then deflected toward Richard Dent. Marshall, number 58. He did not go to the Pro Bowl last year. Singletary and Wilson did, and some of the coaches felt that Marshall was as deserving of that honor as any of the Bear players.
What an intimidating player Richard Dent is. I don't think I've ever seen a quicker defensive lineman, and great instincts as to when to move and where to move. Lines up very often way wide of those tackles, and it's got to just scare the living daylights out of him in a passing situation.
Yeah, and here's his chance, lightning quick, lined up on the far right. Danny White to Dorsett. And Dorsett has a first down at the 23-yard line. Singletary chased him out of bounds.
Just a fraction of an inch separated Dent's hands from Danny White's back. You can almost feel those fingernails down his back, but Danny White able to get that ball off quickly to Dorsett. And again, that's one of the things that Paul Hackett said they'd be doing. You'll see Dent go right across behind Danny White, right there, just barely missing him. But that's the kinds of fractions you want in your favor. And of course, Tony Dorsett knows what to do with that football. First and 10.
Carl Poe, they like him very much, number 81 from Alabama State. He's out to the right side into the game for the first time. Hill to the far left. From the 23, fake to Dorsett. Down the middle, wide open. Tony Hill at the 43 and down at the 44. Another Cowboy first down. Dorsett and Fensick with a tackle.
22-yard pickup by Tony Hill, who's still a fine receiver, but who does not have that burst speed that used to allow him to break away. Notice how much time Danny White has here. Unusual to get that much time against this Bear defense. Tony Hill, remembering that fumble earlier, goes to the ground a little more quickly this time.
Well, the Cowboys' number one pick, Mike Sherrard from UCLA, has not signed as yet, and he would give them that blazing speed they'd like to have. Neither number one pick is signed for these two teams. Neil Anderson, the running back. Line. A pickup of about seven more. Mike Richardson on the coverage for the Bears.
One of the things that the Cowboys will be doing more of is moving their players around. They were always in motion, but they'll do even more of it now under Paul Hackett. You see number 82 coming across in motion, breaking outside very quickly on Mike Richardson. And of course, he's got to have control of that football before he goes out of bounds. Renfro with very sure hands, able to control the football. Second and about 4 yards to go.
Newsom trying to drive for that first down. Appears to be short. Dent and Marshall on the stop. I told you about Refrigerator Perry. I guess, of course, the Refrigerator was the first nickname. That came out of his college days at Clemson. And then Dan Hampton tagged him with Biscuit, a biscuit shy of 350. And now with all of his commercials, he's doing everything from cars to cat food to soft drinks to jeans to bacon to fast foods. He now has another one. They call him the Endorser. William the Endorser Perry. Yeah. Someone else said, and of course, with the great Bears of yesteryear, Red Grange, the galloping ghost, they call Perry the galloping roast. Third and short for Dallas. And it's Newsom, the big fullback. Be very close, the entire center of that line, and Perry was there. Newsom knows small back himself at 237 pounds. He's given away a few to number 72 Perry.
And the surge on both sides. Newsom lost his feet as he approached the line, but he's able to lug that football in far enough to pick up that first down. It'll be first and 10 for the Cowboys.
Mike Singletary, number 50, calling the defensive signals. And does any feel that he is one of the best? He's really a throwback to the old middle linebacker days. Not only a hitter, but he really knows that defense and calls it. Trailing 7-0. Minute 20 remaining in the first quarter. Play action fake. Throw to Dorsett. And he's well covered by Otis Wilson, number 55.
Just to follow up on your comment about Singletary, Dick, I think he has a great deal of pressure on him in this situation with a new defensive coordinator. He has spent all kinds of hours with Vince Tobin working to understand the new defensive signals and then to help kind of be the mediator to get the other Bear defensive players on the right page. And I'll tell you, they call him the Samurai. And he is an outstanding leader, just like having an extra coach on the field. And in this situation, very important for him to be in that situation because they have changed the signals, the way they call their signals, their terminology. Well, boy, I'll tell you, that makes things complicated.
Learning a new foreign language. The quick toss is to Newsom, and Dorsett with a sure tackle at the Bear 43, a gain of only 2. Well, the Paul Hackett offense that he's bringing to Dallas is that from Bill Walsh. So you can liken it to, well, Walsh's days with the Chargers and with the 49ers. And Danny White says, he's had to do some work, but he's excited about it. He said, it's the most drastic change we've ever gone through in my 10 years in Dallas. I've always envied Dan Fouts and Joe Montana. Now I have the chance myself, and he's eager to get going with it.
He really does like this new system. And I think the other thing he likes is the fact that with Gary Hogaboom traded to the Colts, Minneapolis, there's no question of who the leader is on this team, and he has things more or less back in his own hands.
Dorsett waved in motion by White. That's Hill open at the 30. Tony Hill, first down at the 24. 20 more yards as the White passing game, and Dallas working well against Chicago's famed defense.
Well, and as you might expect, this crowd really responding to the long pass play. That's Mike Richardson that Tony Hill beat on that play. Richardson, fine athletic ability, at times loses his concentration a bit. Seemed to lose track of Tony Hill on that play.
And that's the end of the first quarter here at Wembley Stadium in London. Down. And this Dallas drive impressively continues now on the ground to Dorsett. Too many Bears to shut the door at the 10. Gary Fensick number 45, who led Chicago in tackles last year, was first there. Now let's go find Paul McGuire.
Dick, I'm a little smarter than that. I'm not getting into mayhem. I'm on the edge of this mess down here on the wall. We're with a Dallas fan and a Bears fan. Tell me honestly, you come to see the players or the cheerleaders?
Definitely come to see the Dallas Cowboys, but the Cowboys are not bad, actually. They're very nice indeed.
We're in the standing room area. How did you two guys get down front?
You just got to push your way through to the front. You know, you don't come here to sort of stay right back there. You've got to push down to the front.
Thank you, Dick. Like you set up with a straight face.
The cowgirls are not bad at all. I do agree with him.
On second down, White looking for six. And has to go short underneath the hill for 4 yards to the Chicago six-yard line. And there's Singletary, along with Otis Wilson. Singletary, who broke 16 helmets in his career at Baylor. He's that kind of hitter. He was a big Cowboy fan as a kid.
I think I broke one in 15 years.
You used those big hands in your arms. You didn't need to use your head, other than to think.
Well, I tell you, he's got two sets of shoulders. Doesn't have a neck, just two sets of shoulders.
Third down. About five, six for a touchdown. Out of the shotgun. The strength to the left. They hand it off to Dorsett. He's at blockers. But it closes again. He gains only one to the four. Phillips and Fensick able to make the tackle after the front line really stripped away the blockers.
I've got to say again that the great mark of run defense is pursuit. How many people can you put on that ball carrier? And even though the blocking was good and the deception was there, out of the shotgun, a running play that you would not normally expect, there were all kinds of black-shirted Bears out there to put the stop on Dorsett.
That's a nice drive, though, Merlin, against that Bear defense. 89 yards. It started at their 7 all the way to the Bears' 4, and now Septien out of Steve Fleur's hold. Field try was a 3. Septien, injury problems last year. Remember, he couldn't kick at all in the game against the Rams, and that's one of the reasons why they drafted Zendejas, who is not here. And it is good. The Cowboys on the board early here in the second period. 22-yard field goal by Rafael Septien. It's the Bears 7, the Cowboys 3.
So, Dallas on the scoreboard. But soon afterwards, Septien missed a chance to bring the Cowboys to within a point of the Bears when he had a 42-yard field goal attempt blocked. We rejoin the second quarter with Chicago in possession.
First down, Chicago. They lead it 7-3. Reitman in motion. Gentry wrapped up by Jesse Penn, number 59. Penn from Virginia Tech was the number 2 pick of the Cowboys last year, and they want very much for him to win a starting job. They just feel he's a superb athlete, could do a lot of good things in that defense.
Ernie Stoutner has really issued the challenge to two of these Cowboys that they should be stepping forward. Penn is one, and Kevin Brooks, their number one draft pick last year, is the other. Both those players in the ball game right now. Strangely enough, Randy White and Billy Bates both still in there. I'm sure because they want to play themselves into good shape, but
that is somewhat unusual. Fuller, he's going to tuck it away. And Steve Fuller is at the end zone. Is he in? No, down at the 1 yard line. Fuller from Clemson. He was the number one pick of the Kansas City Chiefs in 79. Eventually traded to the Rams and then found his way to the Bears as the backup to McMahon. Was a key performer last year.
He certainly was able to keep them in some ball games with McMahon's injury. And this is vintage McMahon running with the football. Speed, and look at him diving in there. And here comes the refrigerator.
And the fans recognizing Perry, 72 in the backfield, and they would love it dearly if he should score. There's no question of, you could put all the teams together, they didn't get as much publicity as William Perry did himself this past week in London.
Ditka put two plays in for him earlier this week. Let's see what they run.
Perry, is he in? He struggles, and he's got a touchdown.
He hit about six Dallas Cowboys right on the line of scrimmage and just kept going like a bulldozer. Look at him. He's just laughing. A 316 plus. And how many stone? 22 and a half stone.
Tough to skip that stone.
Well, I'll tell you, he bounced into the end zone.
Well, he didn't have a hole, just created his own room.
Now watch him here. One hit, two hits, three, four, five. You keep counting, and Terry keeps moving forward. One more time.
To the chorus of the fans here at Wembley. Flag goes down on the extra point. Really a carnival feeling at Wembley, and they have received a due payment for the ticket price they've seen the refrigerator score.
All start on offense. So they'll go back and move it back 5 yards and kick it again. Talking to someone yesterday, and he said, I hope you hear the Wembley rule. And I said, what is that? And he said, you've never really lived until you've listened to the fans here. They chant, they sing. Of course, they really have added to the spice of this game here so far today.
Butler's try for point out of Fuller's hold from 5 yards farther away. And he's got it. So the Bears move up 14-3 on William the Refrigerator Perry's touchdown. We have 1 minute 54 seconds remaining in this first half. Russell Wilsmer from Great Britain, just signed by the Bears, kicks off but short. Levette at the 15. Trying to get outside, cannot, across the 20 to the 22. Let's go back to the Perry touchdown from the defensive perspective. And right at number 54, Randy White. There's White 54 lined up at the inside just off the center. And Perry will come right at you, and it's strictly a matter of his overpowering. He stopped, but struggles and struggles, and while seven of the Cowboys had a piece of him, the biscuit has scored.
It's amazing the kind of power and the kind of agility he has. You look at him and he's got that, he's got a little bit of fat hanging on him.
Yeah, he can dunk a basketball.
He's amazing.
Ballure to Levette. Good block. Levette at the 30. And out of bounds at the 32-yard line to stop the clock with 1:42 left. Vesty Jackson, the rookie quarterback, makes the hit. 12-yard gain on the play. They say here in Great Britain, Channel 4, which is not a part of the BBC, an independent television network that started the televising of American football some 3 years ago. Each year it has doubled, so the geometry or the algebra of all that figures out going from twice to four times to 16 times, and they say somewhere between 6 and 12 million watched our Super Bowl telecast from New Orleans last year, and that was in the wee hours of the morning. In and out of the hands of Todd Fowler, covered by Ron Rivera, 59. Now, Rivera is a man the Bears are going to take a long look at in this preseason.
They certainly are, and sometimes personalities enter the game of football. Rivera and Buddy Ryan did not get along well at all, and Rivera did not get much of a chance to play, and Ryan did not feel that he was going to help this team. Well, Vince Tobin is giving this young man an opportunity, and I'm sure Rivera realizes that what he does here in the preseason is very critical to what he's going to be allowed to do during the regular season.
Well, he was the number two pick 2 years ago out of California. Second and 10. Ballure from Washington screens it. Complete to Levette. And Levette heads for the sidelines and wisely twists out of bounds as a flag goes down. It was near Todd Fowler of the Cowboys. Backer, veteran, holding is the call against Dallas.
Mark Tumiai.
Number 71, offense, still 7-0.
From Hawaii, he played his freshman and sophomore year at UCLA. Mark Tumiai, number 71, a Samoan.
He played in the defense, Dick. Another experiment by the Cowboys as they have moved him over to offense. And, of course, they have a history of taking good defensive players, making offensive linemen. They say he has really made great progress. And his size makes him a tough center to deal with.
Around 285 pounds. Ballure extricating himself. Oh, and then he has the man open. Speedy Gonzalez. Leon Gonzalez, number 83. Was well in the clear had he been able to hang onto the football. Don Thorpe, 76, applying pressure on the quarterback.
Outstanding work by Ballure to get open, and that's just a case of looking before you catch the football. One of the first things you learn about catching the ball is you got to catch it before you look around, and yet even the pros violate that rule.
Gonzalez with
The Cowboys last year had three catches as a backup receiver. Third and long for Dallas with 1:25 left in the half, and the Cowboys trailing 14-3. Fuller under pressure and down he goes. It's whistled dead. He went down under the impact of the rush coming from Al Harris, 90, yep. And Tyrone Keyes, 98.
We mentioned Al Harris earlier. He's back into that lineup after a year's absence. There he is going off, carrying about 15 more pounds than he carried in 84, but that won't hurt him too much if he plays on the inside at that linebacking position or a defensive end. You'll see him right there as he comes in. Don Thorpe, number 96, also in there to get a piece of Pelor. I'm impressed with Pelor. Looks like he's got his wits about him in there, and I hearing from Tom Landry that they're counting on him to step into that number two spot and be ready to play in case Danny White is hurt.
Clock is running down to 55 seconds. The Bears will get another chance to score here at the end of the first half. And here's the kid they're really excited about, the wide receiver from Oregon, Lou Barnes. He's only 5'8", probably not that tall, 163 pounds. The fifth round draft pick. They like him because he can return kicks, and you saw the explosiveness there, and he's also a fine little receiver.
Somebody that the Cowboys are pretty high on too, Johnny Holloway, number 34, the man who made that saving tackle.
36-yard punt and a 16-yard return, and those bright faces that we've learned to enjoy out at the All England Club during the fortnight of Wimbledon tennis, and many of those well-scrubbed youngsters here enjoying this football contest. Fuller underneath to Reichman, hauled down by his jersey. Tommy Haynes battling for a job in that secondary. They like Haynes. Played some time in the USFL. Hand off to Thomas. And he goes forward to the 26, and the Bears will call time. No, they haven't as yet. With the clock running, it's now they do at 18 seconds. Kurt Pfluger from Gustavus Adolphus, number 73, and on that last tackle for Dallas.